Dalton and I are doing another book review for Transfiguring Adoption. And today we're doing a kid's book, right?
Yes.
Loud and clear, what's the name of the book?
Ellie Jelly and the Massive Mum Meltdown by Sarah Naish. Pictures by Kate
Grimshaw.
And I hope I said that right.
Okay. So let's take a look at the back of the book so you get an idea better what the book's about. Ellie Jelly wakes up hungry and ready for breakfast, but Mom is busy with her little sister, Grace. Ellie tries to get Mom's attention. She bangs the table, she makes loud singing noises, but it's no good. Finally, she decides to make her own breakfast, picking up the heavy milk carton and, oh no, spilling the milk all over the table and the floor. Mom gets really angry and shouts at Ellie. Ellie feels all wobbly and her chest is banging. Will Ellie Jelly and Mom ever be friends again? Okay. Dalton, what do you think was this book written for? Was it written for a foster and adoptive audience or just the general public?
The general public? Yes.
Yeah, the general public. So it doesn't directly mention foster care or adoption in it at all, although Sarah Naish is an adoptive mom, so she is very much familiar with that situation and very good and poised in it. She's actually written some other books that we have reviewed. With characters like William Wobbly, Rosie Rudy, and Charlie Chatty. Great books, you should check those out on our website. But with this book, Mom, Grace, and Ellie are, it doesn't directly say that they are a foster family or an adoptive family, they're just a family. And they're having to deal with the fact that Mom has a meltdown. And as a caregiver, I will say that I do appreciate in this story that Mom does have a meltdown, that it's a true-to-life meltdown, and that the actions and the way that she carries it out are pretty true-to-life, so that you can have a pretty good conversation with your kiddos about what it looks like for a parent to have a meltdown, why they have a meltdown, and it does a good job of identifying some feelings that Ellie has when Mom does have a meltdown and how she feels. So you can deal and get into a lot of healthy conversations in this book. But Dalton, I know you're, oh, first of all, age range. I think this is
four to nine or four to probably the end of middle school.
The end of middle school? I think you could probably get away with maybe 10 or 11, depending on your child. But yeah, probably ages 4 to 9 would be great for this book. Let's jump into the illustrations. What do you think about the illustrations?
They're colorful and they're realistic fiction, but they can actually happen, but they're kind of in like a cartoon style, like in a cartoon movie.
Okay, so they're people, so that could be something. They're actually people in the world, but they are done in a cartoon style. The placement of the words on the page and the proportion of pictures is great in the book. The illustrations are colorful, they're engaging. The characters' emotions, everything's going to do to make the story go forward. The illustrations are really nice, so really appreciate that about the book. I think that you're going to do well with the illustrations. I think you like them, right?
Yeah, they're lovely, actually.
They are lovely, yes. Well, that's a little bit about this book. We really enjoyed this book. Again, I think you're going to get into some healthy conversations through this book. Be sure to check out our full review of the book on our website. We'll also have some discussion questions to help you get into some healthy conversations if you don't have the time to think of your own questions.
Yes, sir.
And you can find that blog at what? What website?
Transfiguringadoption.com.
Transfiguringadoption.com. Right.
Everything.
And we're going to have other kid book reviews, including other ones by Sarah Naish, on there that Dalton and I have taken a look at. Also, we also grade the book, so you're going to be able to see what grade this book earned. So that's all that we have time for this book. We hope that we're helping you to nurture and grow your foster or adoptive family.